This is Chris Mara behind the camera at the Spirits of Mexico, a tequila festival in Old Town San Diego. People are saying tequila has matured in the marketplace and is no longer just for margaritas and shots. Let's talk to some of the distillers.
This is a $9,000 bottle. It's 9.5, it's still in silver. It's made by an artist, Carlos Bustos. It's a very difficult technique because we spent more than 1 month to do only one bottle. We have a gold paint. We have a different dross in the gold paint. This is the Mayagüel, the god of tequila. All the labels and the cap are handmade like this. Everything is handmade, and this is Barro Bruñido technique. We have different colors, our number 8, and we have the certificate per bottle. And this is with extra añejo tequila.
That's why this is the most functional art piece, because we have our Dos Amadios extra añejo tequila inside, aged 48 months in virgin American oak.
My tatarabuelo's great, great grandfather, he started making tequila in the 1860s. Then he put his own company in the 1870s, which is Tequila Sauza, of course.
What's the best way to taste a tequila?
Well, we think you always should start by tasting the Blanco tequila, because that's the true essence of what that distillery makes. For instance, every distillery has a different sets of equipment, different style of production, and so they'll have slightly different tastes. And so you should always taste that Blanco, and you should always taste it straight up, no ice. It should never be frozen. But if you like to drink on the ice, well, have your cocktail on the ice, or have your tequila on the ice. But when you're tasting to determine if you like a brand, you want to taste it in a tequila tasting glass, a Riedel glass, or a nice small wine glass. You can use a small wine glass too, that you can get the nose. And I look at four things when you go to do a taste: the nose of the product, of course, the palate, the throat, and then the aftertaste. And the aftertaste can last a couple of minutes sometimes. So don't drink that water right away. And if you like using a lime, well, that's okay. But you shouldn't have to use the lime. And you shouldn't have to use the salt. Might be a lot of fun, but you shouldn't have to. The quick shot, and there are many tequilas that you might still have to do that quick shot, but there are a lot of brands now that have worked on their processes so that they have a very smooth tequila. And if you try our tequila, you'll see it's very smooth, doesn't have that big bite that's typically associated to that bad experience you might have had in college.
Try to keep like the fresh tequila taste and the fresh fruit taste. That's why we try to come like a crystal clear tequila, and as soon as you see, it's just like a light aftertaste of fruit in each bottle.
One of the things that makes us different than other tequilas is that we doubled barrel age our tequilas when we get to our reposado on up. Even our plata is barrel aged for 45 days, which is unique. We use a 2-barrel system once we get beyond that. We start off in French oak for about half the age on the barrel.
In a Scorpion Mezcal, we go through the silver reposado and añejo. It's made from the Spadine or Angostifolia house variety of agave, and we have a real live dead scorpion in every bottle.
Are you supposed to eat the scorpion, like eat the worm?
That's right. It's a FDA-approved scorpion, so it's perfectly okay to eat. We do recommend that you chew it up before swallowing.
Cerva de la Familia is actually a very unique brand. It's an extra añejo tequila, means it's been aged over 3 years. This particular brand is very special to the actual family. It was originally Reserva de la Familia, which means a reserve brand of the family, which originally was bottled in 1995 and made available to the public then. What's very unique, not only about the juice inside the bottle, but also the packaging itself, is that these are actually every year an independent artist of Mexico is actually contracted to actually design and paint these bottles by hand.
Banana?